जय गणेश। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय इंग्लिश क्लास 10 चैप्टर 10 स्कूल्स गुड बाय बाय लॉर्ड एस्टिस पार्सी। द एसेस्ड लॉर्ड एस्टिस पार्सी वाज ए फॉर्मर मिनिस्टर ऑफ एजुकेशन इन ब्रिटेन। द एसे स्कूल्स गुड बाय इज ए मैसेज कन्फर्ड बाय हिम टू द स्कूल चिल्ड्रेन ऑन द ईव ऑफ देयर डिपार्चर फ्रॉम स्कूल। इन दिस मैसेज ही टेल्स स्टूडेंट्स had to become good human beings and citizens in the future. Let us see the school. This is an example or a photograph of the Balgiri High School. And we, the students, you all are well attached to your school, the gate, the campus, the playground, the garden, the classroom, the science laboratory, the library, the office room, the common room, all these things you are well attached with your teachers, your students, your friends, with all. So you have an attachment with the school for 10 years. So saying goodbye to school means saying goodbye to your family. You see, let us see a classroom, Indian classroom. The teacher is teaching to the students in the classroom. Okay, and this is a classroom in Ukraine of Russia. The teacher is teaching, then the teacher students are involved, and this is the classroom in Ukraine. And this is an American classroom. You see, the madam or teacher is teaching, and the students are engaged in learning. And this is, you see, a German school system where the students are in groups, they are involved, and the teacher is a facilitator here and facilitates the learners to discuss that these students are in groups are learning. So this is, you see, a Japanese class. You know, Japanese class is very regimented, very strict discipline is there. The teacher teaches the students in the way the students are to learn. That is a regimented. So this is Japanese class. So let us read the chapter Schools Goodbye by Lord Estes Percy. We know this is your final year in English. You are class 10 students. You are going to leave school soon this year. You will say goodbye to your school soon after your test examination is over, won't you? Your last day at school will be sorrowful one as you are going to leave it for good. You won't be able to enjoy life at your school ever again. You feel emotionally attached to your school. When you say goodbye to your school, is just like you say goodbye to your own family. But your education does not end here with the end of school. So you move out from school to the wider world to prepare yourself for facing the challenges in life. And let us read the lesson, how to learn how to face the reality of life. Okay, this chapter is a very nice one, and this is a message, this is an advice of the former Minister of Education of Britain to the students of class 10, those are going to leave school. Let us read the chapter. Read the text, Schools Goodbye by Lord Estes Percy. You are now about to leave school, and before you go, we desire to send you our best wishes for your future welfare. You are now about to leave school, and before you go, we desire to send you our best wishes for your future welfare. You see, welfare means good and happiness. Happy and healthy. Okay. That means Lord Estes Percy, the then Minister of Education of London, or the author or the writer of the text, Schools Goodbye, he gave his best wishes to the students, those who are going to leave the school, and that they would do well in their future, for their future welfare. Okay, so although you are parting from school in which you have spent so many years, We hope you will not forget it and think that your education is finished. You see, you are the author says that those class 10 students are the final year students. You are going to leave your school. You are parting from your school this year after the text examination. But we hope you will never forget why you are educated here. This institution or school has given you perfect education to build up your career. So the author here advises the students that those who are parting from school should not forget this school and think that education is finished. And he also advised the students that students should not think that with the end of school education is not finished. Education is a continuous process. It begins with birth and ends at death. Okay. In whatever trade or profession you desire to follow, you will soon find that if you are ambitious to succeed in it, you must continue your education. You see, the second paragraph of the text, the author says that after school education, you will take the choice of any trade or profession. And you should be careful. You should be very sincere about the choice of the trade or profession you desire to do. And you should choose that one. You should have that choice which will lead you to your success. So if you are ambitious to succeed in your life, you must continue your education. So the author here advises students that should to continue education. We should continue education after school also to achieve our end, to achieve our ambition. Okay. So success in life is not easily secured. It only comes to those who work hard and continue learning. So success comes by two things. To achieve success in life, one should work hard and continue learning. So working hard and continuous learning will give us success. We should keep in mind. So we have seen, we are discussing that the author of the text School's Goodbye, Lord Estes Percy, gave valuable advices to one and all. You should keep in mind which will help you in future. Okay, come to the next paragraph. Very soon you will require to choose a trade or profession. And the writer says, after school, you will require to choose a trade or profession, occupation, which life you will take. It is needful. Choose with the greatest care and avoid as far as you can any occupation that leads nowhere. This is the advice of Lord Estes Percy. And that while we take the choice of the profession or trade, the student should be extra careful and should avoid as much as far as you can any occupation that leads nowhere. We should not have the choice of any occupation, trade or profession which is not available in locality, anywhere. So that type of occupation should not be taken as choice. Okay. Aim rather at work that has in the promise of an interesting and happy future. Aim rather at work that has in it the promise of an interesting and happy future. That means the author advises the students to take the good choice of any trade and profession which will promise them an interesting and happy future. Okay. And if at first you are forced to take a job that can only last for a short time, try to get one as soon as possible that is to your liking. That means another choice is option is there. If you are given a profession or trade or occupation which you do not like, You can change it, you can avoid it, and you can choose, you can take the occupation, trade or profession of your choice as soon, and you should change it according to your choice, as according to your liking. If at any time you are in doubt as to the choice you should make, do not hesitate to ask advice from any of your teachers. And henceforth, Lord Astis Percy, the author of School's Goodbye, also advised the students that if you are in doubt in taking the choice of trade or profession or occupation, the students should not hesitate to ask or take the advice from one of their teachers, because they are well experienced, they can guide, they can give, they can help them to take the choice. Okay, so let us discuss the next chapter. Next paragraph. Success in life depends largely on good health. So it is said that when wealth is lost, nothing is lost. When health is lost, something is lost. When a character is lost, everything is lost. So health is inevitable. Success in life depends largely on good health. Good health is essential for success in life. One who does not possess good health cannot achieve success. So how to keep good health? Keep your body fit and buy cleanliness, fresh air, regular habits and suitable recreations. Make yourself strong to play the game and do it in every sense of the word. So then we can make a fit, we can keep good health. To keep good health, to keep our body fit, we should do, what should we do? We should do by, or we can keep our body fit by cleanliness, that is essential, and a fresh air and regular habits and suitable recreations are necessary, and we should be strong enough, we should participate and play the game, do the exercises. All these things are necessary to keep our body fit. So avoid anything that will sap your health. We should avoid bad habits which will sap our health, which will weaken our body, gradually weaken our body. So smoking and drinking should be strictly prohibited. Why? Smoking in your youth stunts the body and clouds the brain. Stunts the body means it to prevent something or somebody from growing properly. So smoking in the youth stunts the body and clouds the brain means make uncertain or confused. The brain become confused. So smoking in your youth stunts the body and clouds the brain. And be temperate in all things. Be temperate in all things means we should control our passion and emotion. So then we can succeed. So be temperate. We should control our greed. Be temperate in all things. And beware of a drink. Beware of a drink means drinking wine, alcohol like this, which is like smoking is injurious to health, drinking also injurious to our health. So the students should beware of a drink. Okay, so drinking, it is the deadly enemy of health and efficiency. Drinking is the deadly enemy of health and efficiency. Okay, so we have discussed the part one of this text. The essay is School's Goodbye, conveys a message to the school children by Lord Astis Percy, a former Prime Minister of Education in Britain, that how to become a good human beings and citizens in future. Okay, so let us read the text and you will find some unfamiliar words that you do not know meaning. So let us discuss those unfamiliar words. You should read and remember and keep in mind and memorize. Welfare. Welfare means the health and happiness of people. A popular government should serve to the welfare of the people. Okay. Part from means to leave someone. The students of class 10 are parting from school soon. Ambitious means actively seeking success, wealth, status, etc. If you are ambitious, you should work hard and continue learning. Succeed to achieve a desired aim. Succeed if you work hard, you will succeed in the exam. Secure to obtain something. My friend Raj always secured 95% marks in aggregate. As far as means to the last extent, you should work hard as far as the work is complete. As to means formal, about, concerning, as to your decision, we have to wait for a year. Recreation means a hobby, a amusement, game or pastime, a pleasure hour. We should not waste, you should use a recreation properly by reading good books. Sharp means gradually we should avoid all these things which will sap our health. Now we should avoid drinking, smoking like this, which will sap our health. Sap means gradually weaken our body. So start here means to prevent smoking something, prevent something or somebody from growing properly. So smoking in youth starts the body. So smoking is prohibited everywhere for everybody. Cloud here means as a verb to make us uncertain or confused. Smoking clouds the brain. Okay. So we have already discussed the word meanings and read the text and discuss the question answers. Do the activity one. Answer all the questions. Who is the speaker? Lord Astis Percy is the speaker here. Who are the audience? The students, those are the final year students, those are departing school from school are the audience. Why is it necessary to continue new education even after leaving school? It is necessary to continue education even after leaving school to achieve our goal. Why do the students seek advice from its teachers for the choice of a profession? When the students are in doubt to take any choice for the choice of a profession, they should not hesitate to take the advice from one of his teachers. What is the most essential for achieving success in life? For good health is the most essential for achieving success in life. How can you keep in good health? We can keep in good health by cleanliness, regular habits, doing exercises, fresh air, good habits like this are necessary to keep in good health. What should we avoid to remain healthy? We should avoid those things will sap our health. That is, smoking and drinking should be avoided. Okay, what is the harmful effect of smoking? Smoking stunts our body and clouds our brain. Why is drink called a deadly enemy of health and efficiency? Drinking is called the deadly enemy of health and efficiency because it deteriorates the health and efficiency of a man. How does good health help us? Good health helps us to possess a good mind, so then we can achieve our success. What are the things that prevent something from achieving success? The smoking, drinking, bad habits, uncleanliness, all these things, those go against a good health, prevent us from achieving success. So let us do the activity 2, answer the questions in a word or a phrase. Question will come, this type of short questions or objective questions will come in your test board exam or text examinations. Who is the speaker here? Lord Astis Percy is the speaker here. Who does the speaker speak about? The speaker speaks about, to the final year students who are going to leave school soon. What is the message of the author? The message of the author to the final year students to be good human beings and citizens of the country. How is success in life secured? The success in life is secured by hard work and continuous learning. What will the students do soon after their school education? The students will take the choice of any trade or profession soon after their school education. Why should we continue education? We should continue education to achieve our ambition or success in life. What does success in life largely depend on? The success in life largely depends on good health. How can we keep good health? We can keep good health by good habits, cleanliness, fresh air, regular habits, and avoiding smoking, drinking like bad habits. Which clouds the brain? Smoking clouds the brain. Which stunts the body? Smoking stunts the body. Let us do the activity 3. In the activity 3, match the words under the column A with B. Welfare, B. Health and happiness. Welfare means health and happiness. Occupation here means profession. Hesitate means reluctant. Recreation here means festive. Sharp here means weaken gradually. Stunt here means VI here means matches to H, prevent growth. B double I cloud here matches to confuse. Temperate here, 8 B triple I matches to A. Temperate here means self-restraint. Let us do the activity 4. Fill in the blanks with the suitable words. They say school's goodbye conveys a message to the school living children. Lord Astis Percy was a former minister of education in Britain. We should not think that our education is finished. Success in life comes to those who work hard and continue learning. Success in life depends largely on good health. Be temperate in all things. Drinking is the deadly enemy of health and efficiency. Smoking in your youth stunts the body. Avoid anything that will sap your health. If at any time you are in doubt as to the choice you should make, do not hesitate to ask advice from one of your teachers. Okay, so let us do the activity 5. So this is the subjective. You will find some subjective questions and all long time questions. How to write? Answer the questions in 50 words. How can a student lead a healthy and efficient life? A student should try to keep his body fit. One should make oneself strong to play the game by cleanliness, fresh air, regular habit, and suitable recreations. One should avoid smoking, drinking, and anything else that weakens health, stunts the body, and clouds the brain. In this way, a student can lead a healthy and efficient life. If you answer in such a way, I think you will get the good mark. Okay. Another example of long question. Why should the students avoid drinking and smoking? success in life depends largely on good health. Smoking is injurious to health. The students should avoid anything that will sap their health. Smoking in the youth stunts the body and clouds the mind. Drinking is the deadly enemy of health and efficiency. So, students should avoid drinking and smoking. Okay, I think you can answer long questions which will come like this. So, we have already discussed. Let us discuss the summary of the lesson, or this part we have already discussed. Keep in mind and listen to me mindfully. The topic "Schools Goodbye" is a message to the school students on the verge of departing their school by Lord Eustace Percy, a former Minister of Education in Britain. The author sent his best wishes to the school leaving students to become good human beings and citizens in future. He inspires them to continue their education to fulfill their dreams. Success in life is secured by hard work and continuous learning. They should choose a trade or profession with the utmost care, which will promise an interesting and happy future. In case of facing any doubt regarding the choice of career, they should not hesitate to seek advice from one of their teachers. Success in life depends largely on good health. The students should keep them fit by cleanliness, fresh air, regular habits, and healthy hobbies. Okay? So they should avoid smoking and drinking that will sap their health. Smoking in youth stunts the body and clouds the brain. Drinking is the deadly enemy of health and efficiency. And control of greed in everything should be the hallmark in students' life. That means be temperate in everything. Okay. So, I think you have read mindfully, read it again, and you will must attain the part 2 of this lesson. Best of luck. Thank you very much, and best of luck once again.